Mannheim and Czechia and Mannheim have some interesting players. But we can talk about it as we go. Czechia being led by Ryan Tannehill. And Mannheim being led by Storm Henry, one of our Discorders. Let's see. Hopefully this won't... Okay, that's what I want to do. All right, Mannheim Panzers versus Czechia Cruisers. There you go. There's the Panzers. The Storm Henry. We've got McCaskill at tight end. And a bunch of names. Without further ado, let's go. And this will be the first official game in the season after all this delays. But here we go, loading. And here we go. The Panzers will host the Czechia Cruisers. It's a day game. It's 84 degrees out in Mannheim, Germany. Cruisers choose heads. Panzers will receive. Hopefully this won't take... I have it at 8 minutes, but it could be too long. We'll see. All right, here we go. The kick is getting away. It's the Czechia Cruisers kicking off to the Mannheim. Oh, God. It told me I might have an issue. Okay, hold on. It told me I could have an issue if I did, like, too many things at one time. Oh, no. Can I change that right now? Hold on. Because it was like, this might be really bad if you put this much info on it. Let's see. News ticker off. Off. I love how it's like even on the Xbox it dies. I think I'll try all names. We'll try that for now. Fan density was the other issue. It was like, oh, if you have too much fan density, then you might be effed. Sorry, everybody. There we go. Here we go. All right, kick is away. It'll be fielded by Zach. Zach up to the 20. Zach to the 26-yard line. A gain of 20 for Damian Zach. And the Mannheim Panzers. Here we go. Henry will take his first snap of his career as the quarterback of the Mannheim Panzers. Henry dropping back under pressure. Dumps off to Amon. Amon tries to make a man miss. And it'll be tackled by Thomas. That's a lot of math right there. That's be a second and seven. A gain of a couple here for the Mannheim Panzers. Henry dropping back. Henry looking, dumps off to Stau, but Stau's going nowhere. He's stopped by King in the backfield. Danny King with the big hit. As you're looking at the offense popping up here for Mannheim. Henry in the third down situation, third and long, in the gun. Back is set to his left. Here comes Henry, looking, firing, caught. But it'll be well short by Llewellyn. Fourth down for the Panzers. That's Horth Tomasili. Looks like the punt team is out for the Panzers. Mays to punt it. Shank punt, we're told. But let's see. It looks pretty... Oh, it's pretty bad. It's Ormond on the return. Ormond for the Cruisers. He'll get it all the way up to about the 34-yard line. And he'll give way to Ryan Tannehill. In our world, the HFL, he is a bust for the Detroit Lions. After being released by the Titans, and now he finds himself over in Czechia. Tannehill. Under pressure, Tannehill firing deep, swatted, caught! It's caught by Jameson Williams, the Lion who's under a ban for gambling. He's over in the HFL. What a catch by Jameson Williams. Unreal. It was a bobble swat, and Williams got it. Coop, up the middle, Coop with a spin. What a game by Darius Coop. The Czechia Cruisers moving against Mannheim right now. Tannehill with one back set. Tannehill dumps to James. James takes the outside, but Sugar has him. A massive loss on the play. Third and seven now. Suddenly this drive looking great. Now it has to gather itself together suddenly. Tannehill. Under pressure. He'll fire. Guess who? Jameson Williams. It's a Lions connection hooking up. And Williams had to wish he never gambled. But. Tannehill, been good so far. Dumping to Coop. Coop has room. Coop has a first down and more. Coop will be taken down, but that's a first down for Czechia. What a strike from Ryan Tannehill. He hasn't missed a throw yet. 3 of 3, I believe, on the day so far. But now it'll be a strange set here. Triple back set. Looks like a wing set. He'll be dump off to James. James has lead blockers in Loha. Oh, nice tackle by Stabler. James was rumbling, but only stumbled for 1 yard. Now, 2nd and 9. Tannehill, back to Coop. He's looked good today, but this will be stuffed. 8 yards just on the day, but they were a nice 8 yards. Coop, number 11, the long hair you see. Tannehill, what's his play on 3rd and long here? Mannheim can shut them down. Tannehill, all day to throw, and then some passes into coverage. Williams, they're going to give him the first down. I think he might have been short. But Williams, Tannehill to Williams is a major connection here so far. Detroit must love to see Williams putting it together in this low-level competition. SWAT, it could be picked. No, Wyatt wrestled with the SWAT, but it should have been intercepted maybe by the Panzers, and it wasn't. So, Czechia. Dump to Coop. Coop has room. Good block by Bosher, but Hood is there. Third and 7. The fans in Mannheim, Germany getting loud right here, right now. Mannheim looking to stop Tannehill, but it's all the way in there, James. He's in for the touchdown at 6-0. Czechia. That was an 11-play, 66-yard drive. Ryan Tannehill showing he can still play. Even at his advanced age. Here comes the kick. Tannehill to hold. Vicks on the kick. And it's good. 7-0. Czechia over Mannheim. A good kick here by Vicks. It's deep and long. Down to the 5. Zach on the return. He gets them to the 21 and more. 30, almost 30, 27-yard line, excuse me, for Damian Zach. A nice return for Zach. See if Henry can get things moving with Mannheim here. Trips, air raid looking set. Henry dumps again to Delaney. Delaney spins off a man and rumbles his way for 5. Mannheim, Henry is still in the gun. Number 10 is back. He'll dump it off to Folks. They love to run, the Panzers, so far. And that'll be a 2-yard gain just, though. It will be 2nd and 2 for the Panthers. Can they pick up their first down of the contest? Henry, another run. Folks, does he have enough? Oh, it's a measurement upcoming. Here comes the chain gang. What's the ruling? Looks short. Oh, they're going to say first down. I'm wrong. First down, Mannheim, that's their first of the game. Okay, here we go. Let's see if we're going to get some passes. Number 42, McCaskill, another Discorder. He's on the... Oh, he's just split out wide now. Iman, though, McCaskill throwing a few blocks. Iman, no yards gained there. Asher Iman. Amon. Henry. Again in the gun. Back set. He'll hand off to Folks. Folks will go nowhere. Chan Folks is shut down. 3rd and 9. It's been a familiar sight this game for both teams. A 3rd and 9 situation. Henry calls a man in motion. Henry looking. Pressure all over him, though. He's had pressure all day, and he's had to dump it off. That'll be well short again. It's 4th down for Mannheim. Danny King with 2 tackles on the day. Will they set up a field goal or a punt? Looks like a punt here. Smart, because they're on their own side of the field. Mays. Oh, Mays shanks it again. Oh, but he might get a good bounce here. It could be a fumble. Ormond, though, picks it up on the run. And he'll get down to the 39, a 13-yard gain. You can hear the on-the-field mic, a big one player calling holding. Tannehill, can he add another great drive to his resume? Pressure, though. Firing into coverage. Oh, are you kidding me? Another catch in coverage. We're going to try to get the name for you. Scott Bosher. Scott Bosher with a big haul in. It's been contested catches going the way of Czechia all night here. Tannehill Firing. Open is Walters. Walters. Take down by Wrestle. Man, Walters. This could actually be too long of quarters. We'll have to take a look, you guys. But for this stream, we'll do it as is. And I might adjust as we go. But Coop. Coop is going to go nowhere as the first quarter winds to 2 minutes remaining. Mannheim has them in 3rd and 5. Can they shut him down in front of Germany's fans? Tannehill, several counts, firing. Oh, whiffed on that throw. Tannehill grounds it into the dirt, nobody home. And that will bring up the punt team for the Czechia Cruisers. Oh, field goal team, my apologies. Vix from deep downfield. Oh, it's true. Holy God. I was drinking coffee. I wasn't ready for that. That's a 56-yard haul for a 10-0 lead. What a kick by Vix. Early impression for the star kicker. Zach now on the return. Zach spins, moves, cuts through, water bugging. Oh, nice moves from Damian Zach, a 24-yard return. And remember, even if it's not our Discord people or ex-NFLers, these guys can make the impression to make the league in future drafts as well. Pro League, here comes Folks. He's got a whole block. Look at Henry. Henry leading the block. Folks down the field. The 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. He's gassed out, but Folks is going to go all the way. He had Henry leading the charge on the block. That's going to be one to see for later. Henry helped spring. He had a convoy 74 yards downtown for Chan Folks. What a run. We had a game here, 10-7. Henry holding and Garrett on the kick. Garrett is true. 10-7. Wow, what a run, you guys. That's going into the highlight reel. You gotta love the quarterback leading the block right there. What else more could you ask for? Good job, Henry, in his first career game. Oh, it was a fair catch call. It looked like a bobble. I'm not sure what happened there. Maybe it was a bobble and it just hit the end zone, actually. Now, Tannehill. Got a set and respawn. Double back set. Dumps to Coop. Nice defense. Feliciano on the tackle. That was a heck of a run. Tanny. Firing. Oh, it could have been intercepted. It's batted down. Nice defense there. Let's get a name for you if we can. I can't, unfortunately. My apologies. Tannehill, they've loved to pass here, but he's sacked. It's Damian Zach on the defense, coming hot off the edge. What a amazing set of returns and all kinds of things for Zach. He's making an impression here as Damian Zach. Now here comes Grayson on the punt. That's going to go deep. Zach, the man who just made the sack, he'll return it. The more you can do, right? The more you can do. Zach down to the 50, looks like. They're marking. No, sorry, the 49. Henry, is he feeling himself now after helping his man down the Chan Folks, that is, leading the charge. Now trips to the left with Folks in the gun. Henry. Dumping to Folks. Oh, it's a dangerous throw. London almost had the pick. London did almost have that pick, you guys, but oh yeah, this is actually pretty long, eh? 8 minutes, a little long. We'll make note of that. Deep down the field is Henry. It's McCaskill. He was targeting McCaskill, but McCaskill couldn't come up with it. It says it was batted. He was looking for McCaskill. It looked like he might have got his hand on it, but unable to do so. A shank punt here, but it could be good. No, it's going to go way into the touchback. Because this is a pretty long, what we'll probably do, you guys, is I'll probably pull the stream down after this, fiddle the settings, and bring it back up for the next games. But we're going to play this one as is. Unless it becomes a blow, then we'll probably sim through it. Tannehill firing to... Oh, Williams, it's knocked loose. Sean Collins was there. Jameson now, he's the main target, but now to Coop. Coop has the edge. Coop, can he beat Russ Ressel? No, Ressel takes him down again. That's a couple times we've seen an open field tackle from Ressel. 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Tannehill from the gun. Blocking breaks down, but he'll find Westerland for the first down. Czechia leads 10-7 as the first quarter comes to a close here in about 8 seconds. Lanahan is in his first carry of the day, but kick Bergman with the tackle. That'll be the end of the first quarter. Second quarter. Tanny plays to Lanahan. Again, his second carry. He finds a bit of wiggle room, but not much. It's a gain of two. So far, the play of the game's got to go to that run for Mannheim. Led by a convoy. Tannehill looking to make his own play of the game, though. Firing into coverage. Oh! It's a hit. Knocked loose. Could have been ruled a fumble. They won't, though. They'll call it incomplete. Tannehill sitting at 61.5% completion. And we'll see the punt team, I think, for the third time here. Punt is up. It's nice coffin corner, but Zach will return across the 20. Damian, Zach. 31 yards returning so far. Henry, can they take the lead here? Momentum is with Mannheim. Man in motion. Hand off to Folks. They love this. They won't love that, though. It's a textbook tackle by Ignato London. Back to Folks. Heavy workload. Chan Folks. He's got 83 yards. In the early goings, he's on pace for 100 easily today. Way more than 100. How about 200? Henry on third down. Firing. Oh, no. It's intercepted. He's going to want that one back. Henry throws his first career interception. It was double covered. He had to not go that way, I think. And he did. And that will be Tannehill's deep in opposing field. It'll be Coop. But nice hit by Damien. Zach once again. He's everywhere today. Get him in the Madden draft class. Damien Zach. Hand off to Coop. Coop. Tannehill blocking a little. Coop takes it for 4. Tannehill. No pressure, but he'll dump it into heavy coverage. It's batted away by the Mannheim defense. Sean Collins again. Long field goal. Vicks really can hit these. We've seen it. It's deep. It's long. It's straight through with plenty more to go. What a weapon is Vicks. A 51-yard blast. 13-7 is your score here. Early in the second quarter. Zach on the return. Down to about the 18. 19, perhaps. Now, Henry, still a one touchdown game here. Leading this offense has been run heavy. Pressure's on Henry, firing up to Llewellyn. That'll be a first down. Nice throw under pressure. Henry had all kinds of cruisers in his face. Henry. Dump is to Folks. Folks up the middle. Folks, another convoy developing, but not able to get that huge lift. But it's 11 yards on the pickup. 11 yards per carry. My apologies. 11 yards per carry. That's a hell of an average for Folks. Henry dropping back. Fires. It's swatted. Batted down at the line. Henry's just 7 of 10 for 25 yards and an INT. Not the start he wants today. 3rd and 3. Triple backs in for Mannheim. They'll give it to McGrory. The first time we've seen him, he doesn't have speed at all, and he's going to go down way in the backfield. I don't know about that call, you guys, because McGrory was trying to bounce it outside, but Lewis Ormond was there. May's not having a good punting day. It's a terrible punt, and Ormond's going to return. Ormond, he'll get it up there, 37 yards today. Now, can Czechia put this beyond some doubt? Or at least open up a two-score lead, I should say. Coop with a convoy. Coop. No, Zach is there again. Damian Zach. He's all over the field today. He's got one sack, three tackles, a bunch of return yards. You've got to love Damian Zach here right now. Tannehill firing. He's got Lanahan up the middle. It's a first down. Czechia. 12-yard reception for Jace Lanahan. Now, multiple backs. Lanahan, the back. He'll go nowhere. Will Lanahan, Damian Zach, blew right through the line. And like I said, he's been making a name for himself all day. Has Damian. Tannehill, second and 13, firing into coverage. Oh, it should have been intercepted. Tannehill just 56.2%. He started so well. And we are singing his praises early when they took that 11-play drive in the opening drive. But since then, it's been tough. Pressure on Tannehill. He's going to try to run. He'll get nowhere. Stabler among the vultures around the ball there. It's 4th and 24, and we'll see the punt team yet again. Grayson. Not a good one from Grayson. Oh, it'll get him inside the 10. He can't ask for much more, but Zach will have some return room. Damian Zach. Across the 21, 20, they're going to call it. Henry still has it, the two-score game. Henry dumped to Folks, and they sniffed that out. It's Kenneth Philpott on the tackle for a loss. Henry, dump is to Amond. Amond. Amond with the stiff arm and spin move. Amond, he picks up 5. His best run so far. Now, 3rd and long, though. It's 3rd and 9. Behind the chains is Henry. Double back set. Henry looking to throw. Henry goes short. Oh, it almost was intercepted again. Lucky it wasn't. Mortimer Morgan was there to knock it loose. Knock it free. Knock it down, rather. Here comes the punt from Mays. A rough day for Mays today. Rough day continues. Punt only reaches the 30, the 45. Ormond brings it back. 14-yard return. Might have to look at a new punter if you're Mannheim. That's a number of bad punts today. Tanny. He'll hand to Coop. Coop gets 3. 2nd and 7. Tannehill firing deep. Oh, he's got Walters down the sidelines. Walters the 20. Walters down to the 16 of the opposing team. He was hauled down by the shoelaces. Whew. My goodness, what a throw. And he broke free, did man Walters down the sideline. What a play for Czechia. And this could be bad for Mannheim. They're doing well stopping the run, though. Just 20 yards only so far for Darius Coop, and he's had a lot of touches. Not a good average. James, we'll get the handoff. James has some speed. James spinning through. Marquavius James, his first carry of the day, I believe. It's 6 yards and a couple shifty moves for James. Tanny. Puts James in motion. James is wide open, but he's going to go low to Coop. He could have a touchdown to Coop. He does. Dump off is to Darius Coop, and Coop is in the end zone. And that'll make it a two-score game favoring the Czechia Cruisers. And Storm Henry's Mannheim debut. Kyle McCaskill still held off the stat sheet. This kick is good. If it becomes a three-score game, we will simulate the rest of it just because this is longer than intended. I don't mean to be see. I know I'm making a big deal of that, but we want to get through seasons, right? So Zach, Amy, and Zach. Zach shifting. Zach has some room down to the 27, 28. Double back set with Henry in the gun, or maybe the pistol. Henry, pressure on. He'll dump it to Amon. He's like the check down. It's check down Henry today. Asher Amon, that's for four. Twenty to seven, your current score. 2 minute drill, essentially, with the 2 minute warning yet to come. Henry. Henry under pressure. Henry into coverage. Oh no. He's got to hold on to that, but Humberto Ellerbe delivered a nuke on his receiver, and that was dropped. That could have been a huge play. Henry dumps it to Folks, but Folks doesn't have much room. That's going to be fourth down. Had to want better there. Looks like they'll send the punt team on. It's been a bad day for Mays and the punt team. That bad day continues. Shanks left and right. That'll get just to the 25. Orman to return. Delaney, nice hit though. Lewis Orman, he'll take it back for 8 on that. See if Czechia can advance the lead before half. Can we get a halftime simulation mercy rule? Swatted, but caught. It's Bosher catching it. Lucky to have that one caught. It could have been intercepted. 2 minute warning is here. We'll take a little, I'll take a little coffee sip and we'll be right back. Coop has some blocking, but not much developed there. He's just 21 yards on the day. Third and seven. Mannheim looking to stop this. And maybe call a timeout. We'll see. They're going to run it. They're content running the clock. Now Feliciano brings them down. They will call a timeout, Will Mannheim. So Mannheim, they're looking to get some things done here as the punt team is back on for Czechia. Grayson. Not a great kick for Grayson. Zach from the 10. Oh, he can't make Williams miss. But a 13-yard run, it'll get him to the 21. Let's see if Henry can do anything with him. Buck 33 left on the clock. So far, his best play, Henry, the rookie, was a block downfield for Folks. Now he's helping with the blocks here, but this gets nowhere. Running is curious, given the situation. Are they going to try to hurry it up? Yes, they will. Hurrying it to the line. That voice, block three. Henry, firing. Close range to Llewellyn. Semi Llewellyn, 3 catches today. Third and 8. They're happy to let the time tick to some degree at least, because they might not convert this. Mannheim 23 could risk giving points. They're going to actually run it. They're going to go outside again to McGorry. And this is never, oh, it's a fumble. Oh my goodness. This play has been absolutely dreadful. This bounce out to McGorry. And Kyle McCaskill, you might have seen it on your screen. He averts the disaster by getting the punt. Good job, Kyle. Getting the fumble. My apologies. Ormond, this is on the plus side of the field. This is not what Mannheim wanted with 44 seconds left and a 2-score deficit already to overcome. If this goes in the end zone, we'll give Mannheim one more drive. Tanny, pressured. Firing. Whoa, that's way out of the field of the play. Tannehill just 12-20. Not great. 39 seconds left on the clock. Tannehill. Pressure is heavy. Oh, it's swatted down. Spencer Feliciano was in on that one. There was a 2-man coverage, actually. Third and 10. Mannheim still has 2 timeouts. Wonder if they call one, if they stop them here. Tannehill. Pressure heavy. Fourth down. That goes nowhere. The O-line just crumbling in front of Ryan Tannehill here. And he's seeing his percentage drop as a result. It's fourth and 10 for Czechia. Grayson. Punt is away. Oh, my goodness. That's inside the 20. He'll take it. The 13 of Mannheim with 28 seconds left and two timeouts. Let's see what Mannheim calls here. They've loved the run game. Are they just going to run it to the half here? Or are they going to throw? Let's see. And in motion, Henry. He'll hand it to Folks. That'll go nowhere. If they call a timeout, then they will not. They're just going to play it easy going. Clock running. 20 seconds and counting here. 18. Second and nine. Dump is to Folks. Folks, the big run, but nothing since, really. 7 yard average still. Third down, and they're just going to let this thing tick. Will they hut one more play? Time is ticking in the half. They will. It'll be to Folks, and Folks will make a man miss. Folks looking to make multiples miss. Not going to happen, and that's the end of the half. And Czechia Cruisers lead Mannheim in Mannheim, Germany, 20-7. You can see the stat screen favoring Czechia in almost every category, except rushing yards. And off we go to the second half. What can Mannheim do? Well, they'll have to start it out on defense. Czechia, Ormond, return, 30, Ormond. Ormond the 40, Ormond the 50. He's got Glendening, he's got him beat. Ormond down the sidelines, 30. Glendening is catching up to Ormond. All the way down, a 62-yard return for Lewis Ormond, and that could put this thing on ice, giving our mercy Simrule. Tannehill, Coop, makes men miss, Coop springs free, Coop down the right side, Coop is in the end zone, that's his second touchdown on the day for Darius Coop, and what a run, whoa. What a run and what a return. That was one play, a 22-yard scamper for Darius Coop. Worked his way through the end zone. And that'll be 27-7. Czechia. Let's see. Mannheim has one more drive before we switch to sim mode. Can they do something? If it even lets me do that, actually. I shouldn't assume it will. Zach. One of the bright spots today. Oh, he sneaks through the line. Damian Zach to the 40. Nice return. I don't know how he snuck through there, but he did. Henry, not having a good day today. Except for that beautiful block. Double backs. Henry, pressure's heavy. He'll dump to Mininger. Loss of yards. Two on the play. Lost, actually. Danny King was there. Second and 12. Henry, he'll drop back to throw. He's been checked down all day, but Folks has room. This is a good check down. Folks across the 50 and into Czechia territory is Folks. Chan Folks has been a lightning plug when he's had a chance to get some open field. A lightning plug, I don't know what that is. A lightning rod of activity when he gets in the open field. Henry now. Henry to McGrory. He's had a rough go. It hasn't looked good. Nusi Ritchie on the tackle. And McGrory is looking, it's looking rough. Second and 11. Henry, dropping back, fires to McGrory. Oh, off comes his helmet. Naz McGrory. Oh, he almost got up throwing fists up there, it looked like. Nice catch and way to hold on to it with that helmet separating from his head for McGrory. Third and 3, though. Key down for Mannheim. Handoff is to Folks, but there's nowhere to go. What do they call on fourth down here? Tavio Van Antwerp there. They will send out the field goal unit for the first time today. Important kick to keep this game in the balance. Looks good. Looks true. Fading a bit to the right, but it'll sneak in there. And play will continue because it's 27-10 Czechia. Ryan Garrett was that with a bomb. Ormond will fumble it again, it almost looked like. Mannheim desperately needs a defensive play here. Coop, though, he's looked good now. He started really rough, but that bounce out run looked, that he looked like something special there. And his second touch of the day. Touchdown, that is. Tannehill. Pressured. He'll fire it across the middle. He'll have his Lions connection with Jameson Williams. Four catches on the day, and that'll be third and inches for Czechia. Handoff. It's a Lanahan. Lanahan hits the outside. Oh, what a stop by Russell. It knocks his helmet loose and holds him for a loss of yards. If not for Wyatt Russell, that was a first down and then some. But Mannheim got the stop they needed. Here comes the punt team. Grayson puts it in through the air. And Damian Zach again on the return. Damian Zach down the field. Zach yet to score, as you can see our statisticians reporting, but he has had impact on the game from the single back. Henry, two man in motion, off to Folks. Folks will get maybe two on the play as Mannheim still trails by two scores. Actually more than, wait, yeah, more than that. Folks, oh, big hit, but it doesn't go anywhere. Folks, oof, gets down. Third down, they're going to need Henry to go to the air at some point here. It's been a run-heavy play call from Mannheim. Henry pressured. Henry going to go long for the first time today. It's caught by Hong. What a throw. And Hong's first catch today was in single coverage, and he beat Linden. Donnie Hong down the right side and caught from Henry, the nice throw. Now, folks, back to the ground game and nothing doing. Lewis Ormond, big name as well. Henry now in the gun, back to his left. Dump is to Folk and nowhere. Third down and long again. Mannheim, double back set. Henry just coming off a long bomb last time he passed it. Henry, pressure's heavy. Fires it to Minninger. It's short of the first down. It's a nice play. What'll be the call here from the coach? Sal Minninger. They will send out the kick team. Draw it to a 27-13. Is it good, though? Oh, he'll get it in there. Yes, 27-13. The Panzer is trying to inch back into this one. Ooh, a nice return on the sideline to Ormond, though. He could have... Oh, Ormond, no wonder he didn't want to just let it go for an illegal kick. He wanted to return that back. My goodness. But he probably, his coaches are probably, gosh dang it, Ormond, you could have had free yardage. And he'll probably get an earful for that, but a couple nice moves on the run. He's looked nice today. Tannehill. Firing into coverage, it's Wittick. He'll beat Damian Zach. But here's a measure. The ref calling for the measuring crew. First down is the call. Let's check ya. Let's the clock tick down a little bit. What we could do is actually go, speed up the clock Madden style. I forgot to do that. Like where it auto burns seconds. Pressure's from Zach, but he'll get to Jameson Williams. His fifth catch. Tannehill has two scores on the day. Tannehill, pressure's heavy, deep downfield, there's nobody home. Oof. He missed them by a country mile, right to the O in Old World, which is the conference that Mannheim plays in, and Czechia for that matter. Intra-conference rivalry, it's third and one. Tannehill will throw on third and one, pressure's huge, he's got Williams open, but he missed it. He's gonna want that one back when he sees the tape. Because that was a first down. But Mannheim's in full throat now. You can hear the fans. Grayson. He gets it inside the 20, but Zach will have room to return. Williams again on the tackle. The 24-yard line is Mannheim. And just put a field goal in last time. 3 minutes remaining in the third. Handoff is to Folks. That'll be dropped for a loss. A beautiful play by Horst Tomaselli. Folks goes in a wide receiver position. Oh, Jones just cuts through. And Henry goes down in the sack. He had no chance on that one. That's Kellen Jones with the tackle. Henry, long count. He'll fire short to McCaskill. It's McCaskill's first catch of the day, but it doesn't go for much. 3 yards. And that'll lead the punt team out for Mannheim. Mays. A brutal day for Mays, and this isn't going to be any better. Down to the 25-ish, maybe the 27. Orman now. He'll take it across to the 38-yard line. Make it the 39 for Czechia. Czechia leading by a nice margin here and on the ball. Tannehill dumps to Coop. Coop hesitates, stutter steps, and goes the other way. That looked like a counter or invented that way, and that was a 5-yard pickup. Maybe he did it on the flyer. Maybe it was a counter. Hard to say, but now a triple back set in play for the Czechia Cruisers. Dump is to Coop. Coop looking for a block. Does get one. James down the field blocking, and Coop will force a measurement. It looks like a first down if you ask me. He was well across the yellow. Let's see what they call. First down. Bring him down next time. Number 4 in the backfield. James. Tannehill looking. Oh, there's nobody home, and he'll be sacked. Looked to scramble, but just outside too late. And that's Caleb Washam to the QB. No injuries as of yet, and that's a good sign. When I did some previous looking at these games and how they played, there was certainly injuries. So I have to hope everyone will be all right. Tanny firing to Williams. I believe that's his 6th catch of the day. Jameson Williams. Tannehill. Everybody out wide. It's an empty set for the former Dolphins, Titans quarterback, Lions quarterback in our world. Fourth down, he threw that way out of reach. And Mannheim gets another stop. Defense trying to do their best they can right now. Grayson, what's this one? It said nice kick, but I might have to disagree. That was a terrible kick to the Mannheim 34. Henry's got to get this offense moving, though. Henry, it's Folks again, but Folks, he should hit outside, but he goes inside and gets stuffed by a horde of cruisers, including Horst Tomaselli. Henry moves McCaskill out wide. He'll dump to Folks, though. Zizika will give him a block, and Folks maybe gets 6 or 7 on the play. Chan Folks, if you have him in your fantasy team, he's racking up yards. Heavy workload for Folks, but he's out of the game right now. Triple back set. Henry dumping. Oh, slap down. That was a dangerous play. It looked like a screen setup, but Kenneth Philpott was there, and Mannheim will be set to punt yet again. Mace. He has been abysmal, and his night continues. He gets a good hop for against Ormond. Delaney's there to bring him down. The dying seconds of the third quarter. Tannehill dumps to Coop. Coop with a convoy. Coop meets Feliciano in the open field, and Feliciano will win that battle. 15 seconds and counting for the third quarter. Tannehill dumped to Coop again. Hood was there. A nice bring down. Darius Coop. That'll bring us to the fourth quarter. Czechia leads 27-13 with 8 minutes left to go. Tannehill will throw. Tannehill pressured again. Shugart is there. That's the third sack of the game for the Panzers. Rudy Shugart is your man. And they will send the punt team out again. We'll check you. Grayson, can you get a better punt this time? Yes, inside the 20, but returnable to the 20, the 30, Zach. Williams versus Zach has been a sight all day long in the gunner position. 97 punt return yards does Zach just by sheer volume. Now, is Coop, he's there. Folks is still okay. Folks going to run, but he'll run into a cruiser who had his back to the play. He'll want that one back. He's only a gain of two. Henry. You'd figure we have to cut it loose at some point with Henry. Henry. Pressured Henry. The pass is wobbly. Batted. Tossed around. And it could have been caught perhaps, but it won't be. It'll just go incomplete. And I almost want to say that Henry's lucky on that one. Didn't look like it came out of his hands clean. Henry. Oh, that's going to lead his receiver out of bounds. And Henry's going to want that one back. 24 attempts on the day for Storm Henry. Mays, a hopper. He's been a horrible punter, it has to be said. McGrory is there with a stop. Orman takes that back 9 yards. Chekia in business on offense yet again. Tannehill. Coop. He'll go nowhere but backward. Spencer Feliciano there. Rain has come down. It wasn't always raining, was it? I think it's come down now. All of a sudden, and Matt Livers. There's the name for you. Matt Livers there with the tackle. That's 5 on the day for Livers. 3rd and 12, Mannheim defense is doing everything they can do to keep us in the game, but their offense has not followed suit. Now they got to do one more thing. Pressure on, incomplete. Nice job by the Mannheim defense. That's 30 passes today for Tannehill, and maybe about the 30th punt here. I'm obviously kidding, but Grayson's had a lot of work. Today, he'll put it just inside the 20, returnable to the 30. Williams and Zach, it's been that matchup, even across the other side of the field. But Henry now staring down a must-do situation. A 6:30 on the clock. A deficit of 2 scores. Folks, a deep drop. Folks, a deep pitch. Only a gain of what? 2 on the play? A run of 13 for a gain of 2, essentially? Damn. 2nd and 8. Folks again, he'll squeeze through. Another gain of 2, though. That's just not going to be good enough. Gain of 1, excuse me. 3rd and 7, just not going to help Mannheim win this one. 11 in the backfield, man in motion. McCaskill not on the field. It's notable set. Oh, Llewellyn dropped it. Llewellyn had it. It was separated from him. And Henry will watch as the punt team has to go back out with just 5:58 left. There's still time, but you'd have to think that time, it's getting desperate here. Nice punt here, finally. But Ormond on the hop. Ormond on the run. Ormond gets loose of Llewellyn, excuse me. Whew, what a truck stick. And he got a 19-yard pickup for it. Czechia, their offense has been in neutral since that big run. For a touchdown for 21 yards. Oh, a nice swat. Spencer Feliciano. That's a name we've said a lot. He's batted it down at the line. Hand off. Coop. Nice tackle by Russell. He's had a nice day. 3rd and 6. Tannehill firing deep. It's a long bomb. Nowhere close. About 15 yards ahead of the play. And for another time, Grayson will come out to punt. Trying to drop it inside the 20. He does, but returnable. Williams and Zach all day long. That's a 10-yard return. Henry, 5:22 left. Defense doing everything it can. I've said that how many times now? And McCaskill on them in motion. McCaskill's the man that's the target, but it almost was intercepted by Danny King. Henry would want that pass back. And in motion again. Henry, the long count. He'll dump to Folks. Jan Folks. A 4 yard per carry average today. He started up real hot and it slowed down considerably. Folks in several motion steps here. Could have been a legal procedure. Oh no. That's a man I can't have. Henry is sacked. Danny King was there amongst a horde of others. Time is ticking, but they just got to punt this. Too far deep. Mays will put it only to the logo. Ormond across into Mannheim territory. A nice tackle by Amond. 4:48 left. Plus territory for Czechia. Handoff is to Darius Coop. Coop, stiff arm spinning. The whole D-line of Mannheim was on their butts. But Coop's only able to get 6 on it. Looks like it could be a lot more. Tannehill looks like he's in the pistol. Hand off to James. James gets just 1 or 2. Sean Collins was there on the stop. New back is in. Oh, no, sorry. Darius Coop is still in. My apologies. They'll hand it to Coop, but he'll go nowhere because Washam is there. Fourth down. Mannheim still fighting for this one. That's Caleb Washam, his fourth tackle. A big field goal for Vix. He's had a great day today. Let's see if he can hit it in the driving rain, though. Vix, all the way, long and good. What a kick and what a game for Vix. It's 30-13. 4 minutes left. We'll see it through, even though it technically meets our simulation criteria. Zach, though, he'll return from inside the 1. And he'll only get to the 17, 18-yard line. So a big deficit here. 17 points, 3 scores needed. This pressure's on Henry. He'll dump to Amond. He'll get a couple. Asher Amond, he's got 4 targets. Mannheim. Need something big here. Henry, taken to the air. No, he'll get put to the ground. He's been sacked 4 times today. That was LeBron Sikowski, I believe. LeBron Sikowski with a sack. That's a name, LeBron's. Oh, a back-to-back sack. This time it's 4v4. Parkins knifing through, and Henry needs some help. My goodness. Punting from their own end zone. This offense has been abysmal today, aside from that one play. Kick is in the air. It's a nice kick, actually, all things considered, but returnable. Ormond, Llewellyn. This time, Llewellyn gets the better of Ormond at the 50. Tannehill, designed run. He'll scamper out in game 2. 1 yard run for Tannehill. Tannehill. Fires short to Westerland. That'll put them within 4 of a first down and 2:50 on the clock. 3-score lead. It's looking good for Czechia. Tannehill firing. Wittick. Got there. First down, Morton Wittick was on the catch. Into heavy coverage. Caleb Washam is there amongst others. Mannheim swats it down. Still throwing. It's an interesting call. Haven't seen much Darius Coop here so far. How about James, though? James gets a block, makes a couple nice moves. James is free. James to the 20. Nice tackle by Damian Zakashule, but James busted it Marquavius James, a 22-yard buster. And that is broken the backs of the Panzers, you'd have to think. That's a rear hit to the armor. Lanahan will struggle for one, but the clock's being eaten here. 2-minute warning coming up. There it is. Hope you've enjoyed the game today. I was planning to do three, but I think it might be a little much. It's my first return to commentating, so I might do one more, might not. We'll see, guys. Either way, when the stream is coming to a close, we're simming the week, because I demand myself to get a week done per stream at least, so that way we can keep it moving. So we'll have to see. I might have to adjust my expectations. Thanks for sticking with me, though. I hope to do one more if we can switch the time. 3rd and 6, Mannheim need to stop. Hand off to Coop. He's looking wide. Coop, nowhere. Wrestle is there again. 4th down and a timeout. Called. Mannheim still trying to fight for this thing. They're going to need a miracle, though. Because guess what? It's Vix again. Vix. Easy mode for this reliable A1 kicker. Vix, it's 33-13. Wilbur Vix is your guy. Wow, what a day for Wilbur Vix. I believe he's 4-4 today. And they weren't all short ones either. Zach on the return. Zach needs a big break here. Zach will get a big break. Zach to 40. Zach to 50. Zach to 40 again. The 30. Can he get there? 20. Damian Zach. Is he going to go for Mannheim? Yes, he will go. Damian Zach will bring it all the way for a Mannheim score. An 83-yard kick return. Wow. What a day for Damian Zach. You got to think that HFL Pro League and HFL National League are looking at a play like that. And today's play from Damian Zach, he hasn't given up despite the scoreline. What a return. It's 32-20. It's a two-score game. Onside conversion. Oh, is it not a kick? It's actually like a two-point conversion. Oh, my gosh. It's 4th and 15 to get the onside. I love it. 4th and 15. Henry knows he needs 15 yards for the onside kick to be successful. He's got McCaskill in the open. McCaskill dropped it and it's intercepted. Oh no, Mannheim needed that for the onside kick. He had McCaskill. He had him open. But he bobbled it seemed like. Oh, McCaskill, no. Damn. That's two of our Discordees stepping up together, and I think that'll about do it here. Although I don't know if they're gonna waste time or not. Oh, they will too. That's why you need the hurry up clock. Whew. Wow, that was a sequence, wasn't it? The touchdown, the kick return, the onside conversion attempt, right in the breadbasket it looked like. McCaskill facing the quarterback, and he had a chunk of the zone to himself, it looked like, at least to me, and wasn't to be. It ended up being multiple bats and intercepted. Coop on the run. He'll go nowhere. Darius Coop. He's had a decent day, but the average not great. That'll be a timeout by Mannheim. Their final one. 3rd and 10. 37 seconds. This is pretty much game over. Well, they might have to actually kick it because I think it's 30-second play. Tannehill will take a knee. I think that might be. Yeah, that is going to be it. 4th and 12. The offense stays on the field. That will take the S to the end. It looks like it's going to be a 33-20 ball game in favor of the away team, the Czechia Cruisers, over the Mannheim Panzers. Hope you enjoyed our inaugural look into the HFL's bottom rung developmental league, HFL Arena. I've been Axel Haxson, and we'll see if we'll get you another game or not. End of the game. And as you can see, it's basically all Czechia, except for the rushing yards. Can we see I guess we can't see like individual stats. Oh. Player of the game, it's going to Darius Coop. He had 27 totes, only a 2-yard average, but he managed 2 touchdowns, 1 through the ground, 1 through the air. I don't think he's the player of the game, to be honest with you. But there he is, the Czechia Cruisers, player of the game, 23 fantasy points, has Darius Coop. A workmanlike performance. Meanwhile, let's take a look at the stats. Henry, 17 of 28, just 97 yards and 2 interceptions. Not the intro that he wanted today. Tannehill, 19 of 36, 194 and 2 touchdowns with no picks. Rushing, we saw Coop already. And Folks just got over 100 yards. He really slowed down there. 21 fantasy points, a touchdown, 102 and a long of 74. What else we got here? Let's check receiving. Menninger, Amon, Llewellyn, and Folks. McCaskill, just 1 catch for 3 yards and I think 2 drops. Sorry, buddy. Sucks. Damian, Zach led in tackles. Tomaselli with 13. Wow. The interceptions were by Ormond and Gale. Ormond had a great day. Vix was an excellent player. 4 of 4, 56 long. A punts, 11 punts to 13. That's a lot of punts. That's a lot of punts. So that, there you have it. Our first game, 33-20. It's Czechia over Mannheim. Been Axel Haxson. Hope you had fun this one because I know I did. It's HFL Arena League Network, part of the HFL Connection. See you next time. So, do we do one more game? If we do, guys. If we do, I have to like lower the time a bit. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save. I'm gonna go back over to the main menu. And we're gonna see if we can switch the timing like mid franchise or not. So let's go. Let's go. What are we going? What are we going? What are we doing? Gameplay? Yeah. We're gonna do speed multiplier. Oh no, on, yeah, okay. No, Excel clock, yeah. When play clock runs down to 16 or 21 seconds. Okay. That should speed it up, yeah. Okay. Let's try that, you guys. We'll do one more game, and we'll see how that goes. Oh, sorry, if this takes in our franchise, that is the important point there. So, based on the schedule I presented to us in the Discord, that leaves the next game will be... should be... going to be... Oop, I'm on a week two. That's why I was confused. It should be the Bucharest Brutes versus the Nagasaki Sword Saints. So let's see if it goes the way we want to. Let's watch it live. Tetrian Reigns will lead the Nagasaki Sword Saints against Lynn Bowden Jr. and the Bucharest Brutes. We have to see if the time is ticks faster, guys. Here we are in Nagasaki, the Sword Saints will host the Brutes. And here we go, Brutes will choose heads. Beautiful night for football, guys. Beautiful night for football. Sword Saints gonna take this on offense. Brutes say they'll defend the North. Kick is away from Dalton. Nagasaki. It'll be Harnois on the return. Harnois. Cross the 20 to the 21. Harold Harnois. Now we'll see. I got our first look at Tetrian Reigns, the quarterback. Oh, it did drain the clock, didn't it? Tetrian. Hand off to Burton. Gain of 1. Yeah, it does burn through the clock, yeah. it seems. That should help. Tetrian. He'll take to the air. Reigns firing. Caught by Gaston Bolzer. Empty set, third and five for the Sword Saints. Tetrian's voice is hilarious. Reigns. Reigns under pressure from Bess. Reigns downfield. He's got a chance. Oh, it's bobbled. It's knocked around. Camille Mesh on the coverage for Bucharest. And the Sword Saints will punt. It's Hetherington. On the return is Lynn Bowden Jr., the quarterback and return man. Multi-purpose. Lynn down to the 36, excuse me. Lynn Bowden Jr. under center. High level of athlete, but he'll hand it up to Coverdale. Coverdale, a 2-yard pickup. And the tackle. Came in just the nick of time. Bowden. Bowden Jr. Pressure dumps to Ottman, and he's close to a first down, probably inches. Eldred Ottman is the target. A 7-yard pickup. Bowden in like sort of a double back set, pistol, one man in motion, whip key in motion, the fullback, Bowden under pressure, fires and caught by Gote for a first down for Bucharest. Lynn Bowden Jr. making his presence felt early. Coverdale. Did I say Cloverdale? It's Coverdale. My bad. I said Coverdale, didn't I? I'm not sure what it would be, actually. Hand off. Coverdale. Oh, a helmet pops loose. What a hit by Dante Bolden. Third and eight here. Bowden dropping back under pressure. Bowden has Coverdale. Whoa, what a catch on the move by the back. And Coverdale breaks a tackle, and he's all the way in for Bucharest. And what a play there by Lynn Bowden Jr. Under pressure, put that right where it needed to be. Maybe just a bit further from Coverdale, whatever you want to call him. And but regardless, the Bucharest brute reached and grabbed it. And what a play. Bucharest is in 7-0 against Nagasaki. Yeah, this is a lot quicker of a quarters, I think. Harnois to the 20. Harnois making moves. Harold Harnois to the 24. See if Reigns can get it together now. Reigns to Burton. Burton has no room, really. A gain of one for Jermaine Burton. Reigns. Dumped to Walken. Walkden, excuse me. We've got an injury. It's Matt Walkden. Twisted his ankle. Looks like he's going to miss the rest of this game. Prognosis is 1 week. You hate to see it. That'll stop the clock, though. Reigns. Pressured heavily. Burton is the outlet man. Burton can't beat Tucky. And it'll be fourth down for the Sword Saints. A good tackle by Pedro Tucky. Punt will the Sword Saints. Hetherington. Bowden Jr. Oh, he can't get there. Nice punt, beautiful punt there inside the 20 to the 13 by Hetherington. Bowden, who just sprinted up the field on the return, will hand it off to Coverdale. Oh, what a break tackle! Coverdale beat Jabat Lapierre, had to bring him down because he broke his way through again. Second and six. Looks like a dangerous run game. Again to Coverdale. Bowden Jr. going to lead the block. Bowden Jr. Oh, Coverdale breaks another one. It's Ryan getting tossed aside. Isadaro Coverdale. Woof. He's beasting today. he'll take his spell, I think, here. Yep, Empson is in, and Empson will get taken down by Thomas McGarvey. That'll go for a loss. Second and 11. Defense backs off a bit. Coverdale, are they going to regret this? No, because Klass had to be there. It's Yuri Klass, the Swedish guy. This man from Sweden making that play. Third and long. 15. Third and a bunch. Bowden. Bowden pressured. Firing deep is Lynn Bowden. It's Jeremiah versus Gote. Gote's got it. He beat Jeremiah one-on-one on the jump ball. Lynn Bowden put it where it needed to be. It could have been anybody's ball, but it goes the way of Bucharest. That's the end of your first quarter, 7-0. Bucharest Brutes and driving after a beautiful play on third and a country mile. Bowden. Coverdale. Crossan is there. Isidaro Coverdale. But keep in mind his TD was a pass, I believe, or a catch. Coverdale. Whip key blocking. Coverdale goes nowhere. LaPierre is having words with him. Third and 11. Lynn Bowden. Dropping back. Pressure's on. Firing. He's got Correa. The coverage is bad out there. There was three guys, but they couldn't tighten it up. Cal Correa's downfield for 22. You can hear the frustration from the defense here. And our mic'd up player situation. On the move is Ottman. Bowden looks swatted down. Second and 10, we'll go from the empty. Bowden. Bowden firing, caught by Gote. He's been a weapon today. He'll get just a few. Third and 8. Can the Sword Saint stand tall? Firing close range to Gote. A nice tackle by Harnois. That should set up a field goal for a 10-0 lead. Let's see. Number 5 to kick. Dalton. Oh, the pressure's heavy up the middle, but he puts it through. It's 10-0 Bucharest. That's a 12-play, 71-yard drive, and takes us to the middle of the second quarter. Dalton puts this through the air. Backs up Harnois into the white of the end zone. Harnois across the 20. Nice tackle. Tetrian, we haven't seen it too much from Tetrian Reigns yet. The rookie quarterback. Burton gets the ball from Reigns. Burton gets a healthy pickup of 4. It'll be 2nd and 6. Reigns. To Burton. Burton hesitates. Burton finds his spot. Makes a man fall to the wayside. Burton is so close to a first down. It's 3rd and inches. They won't measure. They'll just call 3rd and inches. It's about the length of the football at most. Reigns will throw on this tight situation. Caught. It's by Bolser. Nice throw and catch. A risky call in that situation, but beautiful. Beautiful execution. First down, Nagasaki. Reigns under pressure, fires it, swatted down by Khalil Lamesh. Nice defense. Reigns. Dump to Burton. Burton shimmies his way through. Burton looking good today now. Time ticking in the second. Reigns, 3rd and 5. Reigns under pressure. Reigns gonna dump to Bolser, but he'll get taken down by Hanscom. And that'll be 4th down, right around the logo of Nagasaki. Looks like a punt, unfortunately, for the Sword Saints. Trailing 10. Hetherington, oh, he's gonna want this one back. It's abysmal. It's abysmal. It's about a 7-yard punt, let's say. Oh, goodness gracious. Let's see what Bowden can do with it now. Bowden Jr. He has Ottman, but he's gonna go into coverage. It's picked off. He'll slam the Microsoft Surface against his head there because Dante Bolden was all over it, and he had Otten open if he looked in the middle of the field. But Tetrian's gonna get the ball with his team in plus territory. Nice interception on Bowden. Reigns under pressure. He'll dump to Burton, and he dropped it wide open. Burton not known for his hands necessarily, and he let that one get away. Second and 10. Reigns, man in motion. Favor is the man. Pressured. Oh, it could have been picked. Raymond Nessler was the target, but he couldn't get there. And instead, the defender had the jump. It's third and 10. Reigns. Firing down the field. He's got Parlier. Parlier to the 20. The 10. Parlier is going to go all the way. It's Tetrian Reigns for CD as the quarterback. And he found Parlier, a 42-yard strike off the back of that interception. What a catch and run and a nice throw. And Nagasaki, the fans in Japan are going wild. We got a 10-7 ball game. Two minutes on the clock. Bowden, the quarterback return man. He makes a little shimmy step. What's he got? Very little. Longest run of the day at 20 yards. 2 minute warning. Well, I say longest return of the day, excuse me, 20 yards. So 2 minutes left, 130 to be exact, 138. What will they do? They'll go with Bowden on the run. He is fleet of foot, but that's Mason Hacking. Brings him way down for loss of four and a timeout by Nagasaki. And why not? Handoff. Wipke, the fullback. He'll get nothing. Chad Wipke. Timeout was called by Nagasaki. It's third and 14. Bowden. He'll look to Coverdale. He'll hesitate, but Bolden, who had the pick earlier, he'll bring down a huge tackle for loss, a big TFL of about four, and it's fourth and 18, punting from the end zone with a three-point lead. This is not where you want to be with Bucharest. Nice punt, though. He'll get Harnois all the way to the 31, but Harnois takes it to the 43. I'm always a yard off. 1 minute, 19 seconds. Tetrian, maybe his confidence is higher after he found Parlier? No real pressure. Tetrian down the field and way too far. Second and 10 for Reigns. Reigns, pressured. Dumps it short to Nessler. Nessler breaks one tackle. He'll make it third and inches. They'll hurry up to the line under the command of Reigns here. Quick snap. Trips wide, but Reigns. Oh, he gets hauled down. Fourth down. Big loss. Definitely not what they want to see, but it's Alejandro Bess on the sack. And a punt team is out for Nagasaki. Hetherington needs a better punt today. This time, and he looks like, oh, it's too good. Bowden takes the touchback. Bad punt in the end. Good length, but too long. Now, will Bucharest press the gas pedal? Bowden Jr. Nope. Coverdale. Barrington Morgan on the stop, and I think both teams content. Well, Nagasaki has no timeout, so it looks like they're content to just chill out here. And off to Coverdale. Another loss, though. McGarvey. Sword Saints had McGarvey, and McGarvey had it done there. 24 seconds. We're going to take it all the way, I think, right? Oh, they'll throw here. Complete to Rash. But it's fourth down, and you have to imagine that that'll be where they let it tick down. They still have the offense on the field. Will they do a last second snap here for a play? My gut says no. It is indeed no, and we'll go to half 10-7 out here in Nagasaki, Japan. And I believe it's Bucharest ball here. Yep, the Sword Saints will kick off to start the third quarter. Hackett Hawkinsmith puts it through the air, rips through those molecules right into the hands of Bowden. Bowden has not looked great as a kick returner here. 17-yard line is all he can bring it to. Coverdale. He's got several losses on the days of Isadoro Coverdale. His biggest play coming through the air today. Bowden way off target. Oh, no, it's caught by Ottman, and he can squeeze about a couple of yards out of it. That was all Ottman, really, because the pass wasn't where it needed to be. Bowden. Bowden Jr. deep downfield. Ottman is the target, and he has it. A first down, Bucharest. The tight end snags it. Eldred Ottman, 25 yards downfield. Bucharest looks to build on their lead. Whipke, the fullback, is in the halfback position. He lowers the shoulder, gets one. But a nice statement by Whipke. Double backs, one in motion. Coverdale, we know he's an aerial threat. I'll go down the middle to Metzner. Morgan was all over it, but Metzner held on. Wilbur Metzner. Nice catch. Bowden Jr. firing. Hotman. Looks like he has a first down. He does. Just by the skin of the football. On the 42 of Nagasaki. That kills me. Back three. Coverdale. Brought down. A loss again. Bowden Jr. has one back. Number 13. Draws another one back in. Ottman. Oh, I don't know what happened there. But it looked like a ball slipped out or was batted down. I'm not sure. Off a helmet maybe. But it's 3rd and 11. That was incomplete. Dropping back, pressured. Oh, that should be picked. Oh, Bolden overplayed it. He had his second pick of the day, staring him in the face, and he overplayed it, and he allowed Ottman. Uh-oh. Oh, no, it's Kellerman, the right guard. They're saying it's turf toe. Oh, dear. Poor guy. But somebody coughing. Eldred Ottman. I don't know if you're able to hear that. It was good. Excuse me, as good as I can on the field chatter, but there's somebody coughing, and that made me laugh. But yes, Bolden had it for maybe a pick six, and instead it gets behind him for a big first down. 2nd and 11 here, Bucharest. Bowden Jr. firing deep, double coverage. Can he catch it? No, incomplete. Risk throw by Lynn Bowden Jr. Third and 11. Big stop would be great for the Saints. Dump off to Gote. He's been great, but Poole is there. 4th down. Should be a field goal set up here. It will be from the baseball diamond. Kick is up. And faultless. That'll make it a 13-7 ball game for Bucharest. Dalton puts the kick out. Puts the kick in the air. Wait, Walkden is actually on the field playing. Walkden, he had a diagnosis of a week, but he's on the field playing. You can see the little injury symbol there. Hopefully he'll be all right. He's pushing himself. Stay on the field for the Sword Saints. Burton Burton breaks a tackle. It was the Matic he broke. And Burton off down the field. Burton making all kinds of statements on that one. Matic, a star player for Bucharest, and Burton put him on the ground. What a run for Jermaine Burton on that one. Ketrian. Dump to Connor. Connor is dropped away in the backfield. It's Kalon Brennan. A loss of two. And it's second and 12. The waning minutes of the third. Ketrian Reigns dumps off to Bessinger. Branson Bessinger. 9-yard catch. It'll be third and three. Double back. Reigns under center. Dump to Burton. There's not much, and he doesn't get much out of nothing. It'll be fourth down. Let's see what the call is, because they're on the plus side of the field. Will they punt? They will. Fourth and two. Hetherington puts it up. Bowden to return. Looking for his big moment, and it won't come now in the return game. The quarterback return man goes down the Bucharest 22-yard line. Can they expand to a two-score lead? Junior dumps to Levi. Hacking says, loss of one. Just 20 seconds remaining in the third. Make it 10 seconds. Empson, he has a convoy, but he doesn't have the speed. He breaks one tackle, though. Does Empson turns positive yardage? Did I just see nothing chalked like a Ron Moose tractor instead of John Deere? Oh, I love it. It's third and eight. Fourth quarter now. Do or die situation. Oh, a nice hit. Jarred the ball from Ottman, I believe. Wow. Good hit. Key hit. The punt team will come out. Rhodes, the punter. First time we've seen him, I think. Puts this through the air. A hopper to about the 34. Harnois picks it up. And he'll take it to the 42. A 10-yard pickup. Still a one-score game. 7:49 left on the clock. Reigns looking for a productive touchdown scoring drive. Reigns firing down the middle. Dangerous. Bessinger was the target, but it was broken up. Double back set behind Ketrian Reigns. One in motion to the left. Handoff. No, it's a pass. Downfield, one-on-one, caught. It's Nestler, over Mesh. Raymond Nestler, a 24-yard pickup. And the Sword Saints in business on the Bucharest 33. We've got man in motion, the back, Bessinger. Looking at Bessinger again. He loves that connection. Branson Bessinger caught for a gain of four. Time ticking for Reigns. Company, three back set. Dump is to Burton. Burton needs a block. Burton gets a block. Burton can't get through that second layer. If he did, he might have made a house call down the left side of the field, but it was not to be. Instead, it's third and two. Bolser, the receiver, gets the handoff. That was blown up. That was a bad play call. Lowie Matic missed it. Looks like it'll be a field goal kick from the diamond. Draw within three. Hawkins Smith. He's money for it. It's 13-10. Bucharest. Victorio Hawkins Smith is good. Uh-oh, this kick looks really poor. Yeah, it's barely crossed the 20. It'll be returned by Bowden to the 34, the 33. So, can Bucharest put this away with either a long drive or a touchdown? Bowden, Coverdale, hesitates, has a lane. Coverdale can't break from Poole. He brings him down after five. That's a mitigation of what could have been way worse damage if you're the Sword Saints. Second and five. Bowden off to the fullback Whipkey, and he's gone nowhere all day. Dante Bolden, fourth tackle. I formation. Make it a bizarre version of that. Lynn Bowden spins away. He's going to throw on the move. Lynn Bowden Jr., what a play. It's just out of the – and that's the thing you can do. That's what we've talked about on the podcast back in HFL 1.0. That's the kind of stuff Lynn Bowden can do. And, wow, he spun around in the backfield and lobbed one deep, but it wasn't in the field of play. Good punt here. Harnois looks to return back. He returned all the way to the 20. Nice return for Harnois. 4 minutes, 4 seconds remaining. Tetrian under center. 13-10. Burton, he'll go nowhere. Kalon Brennan, the man. Reigns empty. Reigns pressured. Reigns back foot throw. Oh, he had him. But Tykeem Boland jarred it loose. Reigns. Reigns. Pressure is heavy. Reigns down the field. Looks like it could be picked. It just came up short. Fourth down. What are they going to do here? Reigns is just 10 for 18. Looks like they're going to punt. The right call. You have to think. But it has to be a nice punt. It's not really. It's up to the 30. Bowden down the sideline. Oh, Nestler blew up the quarterback. Return man after 12 yards. Now, the Sword Saints need a big stop. That's all there is to it. Big stop for the Sword Saints. Time ticking. Coverdale. He'll get loose for about 3 or 4. Just 10 yards rushing on this day. It's not been a banner day for him, except for that TD through the air for Coverdale. Time ticking. No timeout calls. Down their field. They're going to throw it. Incomplete. So that's a free timeout. Got to wonder about the play calling there. And now they'll go empty with Lynn Bowden. Always a threat for mobility. What will he do? Pressure on. He dumps it short. Gote has been good when he's got the ball, but he'll be stopped short. That's what Nagasaki needed. They'll let this tick. Here comes the punt squad. Down the field goes the ball. Harnois picks it up at the 3. Harnois, the 10. Harnois can't beat the tight end who played Gunner there and stopped at the 15. So it's all to do for Tetrian. A 2-minute drill. This is where quarterbacks make their name. Here comes the rookie QB from the Discord. 15-yard line. He'll hand it off first to Burton. Burton tries to explode down the left side, but he'll get just 4 with time against them. And they'll run it to the 2-minute warning. No choice on the matter. Now it's a full 2-minute drill from his own 19. That's basically the whole field. 80-yard drive. This is what it's made out of here. This is what separates the men from the boys QB-wise, but they're going to go back to the running back, and Burton, that's just 1 yard. Third and 5. It's fourth down territory. There's no question about that. Reigns throwing short, and they'll face a fourth down. This is desperate territory here. Fourth and 3. What's their best play call? They have set Tetrian under center. Down by just 3. Reigns. Reigns pressured. Reigns deep. Reigns double covered and swatted away. And Bucharest could have sealed it there. There's still 3 timeouts. But Reigns comes up short when he needs to come up big. At least to get a field goal to tie. Now, they're going to try to run this clock out. But the Sword Saints will make the stop behind the line, and timeout is quickly called. Ray Poole's got 7 tackles on the day. This stop has to happen. Quick timeouts and quick takedowns. Coverdale working his way upfield. They can't allow a field goal. That's Yadiel Sharp on the hit. First time we've called that name today. 3rd and 5. The biggest down maybe of the game. The run goes nowhere. Nice stop by the Sword Saints. And you have to expect a field goal here from the Nagasaki 17 to make it a 6-point touchdown must game with no timeouts left on the clock for Tetrian. Kick is up. It's good. So Tedrin has a chance to win this thing, or at least put it in a tie situation if he can march his team down the field. The quarterback number one reigns for Nagasaki. Kick is into the end zone. Harnois takes it out. Paradiso lead blocking. Harnois chipped up at the 18. Tetrian, 104 left. It's got to be quick. It's got to be efficient. It's got to get chunks. Reigns. Pressured. Reigns is going to fire this one out of... Whoa, what? They called that a catch. There's no way that was a catch, but they called it a catch and a clock stop for a two-yard gain by Olin Fervor. Reigns. Reigns. Pressure's heavy. Reigns. Swatted down. Del Fripp says no. Third and eight. Reigns needs a bit of better blocking there if he's going to make anything happen to take this win. 56 seconds. Reigns. Reigns down the field is caught by Talamo. Oh, wait. No, that was the defender's name. First down and no time. Oh, yeah. Sorry. It's BT Talamo, the tight end. But they've got to hurry. It's 45 seconds of counting. They'll spike the ball. So, second and 10. On just their 29, a long way yet to go and not much time to do it. Defense backs off. Reigns is dropping back. Of course, that's all he's going to do. Bess was providing the pressure, and BT Talamo gets tattooed. Maybe that's for the best that he dropped it, because that would take up more time than it was worth. It was about a gain of like 4 or 5 only. Reigns. Pressured again, like as he has been all day, but it's converted to Burton. How did he get hold of that? But he did. It looked like it was going to be swatted down for sure. They've got to hurry. A 15-yard gain, 30 seconds and counting on the clock. You figure they spike it here. They do. 32 seconds. The Nagasaki 43, only a touchdown will do. It's Hail Mary type situation here for Tetrian Reigns. Burton crosses the face of the quarterback. Burton... offers himself up. Nestler's open. Nestler's down the sidelines. Tetrian could have the win. Nestler hurdles. Nestler, the sidelines. Nagasaki Sword Saints out of nowhere. A 6-point tie game, and the extra point could win it. Tetrian Reigns. It didn't look like he had it going today, but man, did he ever put that through in front of the Japanese crowd here in Nagasaki. And the extra point is good. And the Nagasaki Sword Saints have a late 1-point lead, courtesy of Nestler down the sidelines. What a play. Welcome to HFL Arena. Bowden now. He knows he's up against it. The quarterback and return man. Oh, he's going to want that back. He burned a lot of valuable time. Lynn Bowden, his team suddenly facing a deficit for the first time today, which is 17 seconds left, all three timeouts. What can they do? A field goal wins the game. Gotta be chunks. Gotta be chunks for Lynn Bowden. He's gonna run. Hurdles. Throws. Empson catches. He hurdled in the backfield and threw the dang thing. That was a fun play. But time's against him. 11 seconds. Bowden pressured. Caught by Gote. It's gotta be instant timeout. 6 seconds left. We're Hail Mary time. And if they somehow catch it with time left, they can get a timeout and win the field game with the field goal. But this has to be everything. But he's not in the gun, guys. He's not in the gun. Bowden Jr. Oh, no. This is what he can't have. A time waster. Just 2 seconds left. That wasted so much time. You may as well have just spiked it if that's what you were going to do. Yikes. 2 seconds. This is it. Sword Saints on the cusp of a victory at home to open the season. Bowden goes way too short. Sword Saints pull it out. If you can believe it, their first win of the game comes just 22 seconds left. And the Nagasaki Sword Saints send the fans home happy. A 17-16 ball game. Beautiful. All right, we'll do one more game, you guys, as I predicted we would. Player of the game will go to... Raymond Nestler, the game-winning touchdown. 3 catches, 90 yards, a touchdown. Targets, I think. Throw targets, 6. So 3 of 6 he was. There he is, Raymond Nestler, player of the game. catching just 53%, but when it counted, he put two TDs up. Good for him. Let's take a look at Bowden. He was 70%, but the TD and the pick, 210 yards. Cloverdale was awful on the day, the 37-year-old, averaging just a 1 yard per carry. Bowden ran for negative 4. Burton, a 3 yard average. Balser led in catches, but just 20 yards. It was, of course, Nessler that led. And, of course, there was Parlier, the touchdown. 42 yards in length, his only catch. Meanwhile, Gauthier had 8 for 77. He was a beast. And the interception was from Bolden. So, there you go. The Sword Saints, 1-0. Have had just the hair of the final seconds of the game. Take one more game for you. And I'll call it a stream. And the end of week one after we see Zurich versus Lviv. Just get a save here. All right. Last game of the week. Lviv versus Zurich. Wonder if my team. Ooh, Teal versus Teal. Can I switch their clothes? No, I don't think I can. Well, it's the yellow, I guess. All right. It's Lviv versus Zurich. Couple discorders across both teams. Zurich has Jess Theory and Brendan Goat. Jess, a receiver. Brendan, a free safety. Lviv has Desjardins. And I think that's maybe it in terms of Discord. Let's call it as we see it. Raining day in Switzerland here. Kick is away. Switzerland will return. Gavin, only the 18. He's stopped by Roberts. It's Florentino Gavin. Here we go. Number 4. Levy. Throwing incomplete. It's Valerian Levy to Cauca Lacorte. Incomplete. There's Jess Theory on the side there in the red with the red long hair. Wide receiver. Levy will go. Oh my goodness. Batted back to his end zone. He's 0 for 2. Zurich facing a 3rd and 10. Desjardins on the D-line, by the way, in the middle there. Firing down the field, incomplete. Levy's 0 for 3 to start the game, and it's a quick 3 and out for Zurich. They'll send the punt team on. Number 14, Kirker. Oof, he got some leg behind this thing. All the way back, it pushes Overstreet. Oh, he gets a bad bounce for Switzerland, and the Ukraine city of Lviv is from their own 23. View. Oh, it's almost intercepted. Wayne Favorite broke it up. Gotta want that pass back. Not sure how to pronounce this name yet. Oh, a lightning there. View, throwing downfield. Cook the catch and the first down for Lviv. Aaron View. Number 4 for the Lviv Loyalty versus Zurich United. Man in motion for Loyalty. Lagander for Fernando Pearson's there to make the tackle. The running back. Let's get a double take on that name as well. Vieux. Downfield, caught, is dangerous, but Overstreet's there. for it is third and one for Lviv. Polar on the carry. Brendan Goat, our Discord player, makes a tackle for a loss. Whew, what a hit by Brendan. Hunt team on the field. It's Baron. He'll step into it. Lightning rattles the sky, and Gavin, Florentino Gavin on the return. Nice hit by Wrench. First and 10. Nil-nil the score. Lavi. Caught. I think that was Theory. I think that was just Theory on the catch, her first career catch. Nice job, Jess. Hand off to Strawn. Strawn will get the first down. The Lightning, it's a wonder they're still playing. It's Rob Strawn for two. Hand off to McCullers. McCullers for two. Oh, three for Stevie McCullers. Second and seven. The Lightning still continuing here. Kerrigan on the carry. He busts through, but he could have hit it outside. Granquist there on the tackle. Emilio Kerrigan. Nice, a decent pickup, I should say. Gun now for Lavi. Firing downfield. He's got Jess Theory, and she comes up with it. Her second grab of the game. Good catch, Jess. Love to see it. Lavi to Strawn. Strawn makes a couple miss. He's got to beat Harrison, but he can't. Harrison gets him down. A 7-yard pickup. A nice run by Strawn as it's 2:40 or so left in the first quarter. Still 0-0. Looking for our first points in this weather-laden game. It'll be a handoff to Hooper. First time we've said his name. Cameron Hooper. Not much. Third and four. Lavi firing short. Oh, it should have been intercepted by Lviv. It was Hugo Trout, the target. A long field goal here. Chalkley in the rain. Chalkley. Oh, it dwinked off the crossbar. Chalkley had almost enough. That was a huge kick attempt. And now Ukraine, Lviv, is in business. What can Via do here? Lagenderfer. Rolled Lagenderfer. Oh my god. What a name. Lagenderfer. Goes out wide. He is the receiving man here. Lagenderfer. Rolled Lagander for 6 yards on that one. But it'll be third and three for Lviv. Via dropping back, firing. Has DeBruce. Oh! DeBruce had his helmet rip right off him, but he gets the first down, did DeBruce. First down, Lviv. The loyalty putting something together now. Amidst all that wartime drama, they still play some ball. But Aaron Via, he can't get it to him. 3 seconds remain in the quarter. Hand off, Lagenderfer. Lagenderfer up the middle. Lagenderfer, can he beat Brendan Goat? No, he's good for the tackle. End of the first. That's two tackles for Brendan Goat. By my count. Free safety, number 80. I think it's 80. I could be wrong, but I thought I saw that. Via looking for Toller. No, he's going to go down the field to Cook. Way too far for Aaron Via. That should send out the kick team, if you can believe it. Okoye puts it up. Okoye is good, and Lviv has a lead over Zurich. 3-0. A massive 55-yard bomb. Capitalizing off the missed field goal from Zurich. Now, returning is Florentino Gavin. He'll get taken down by Krieger. See what Zurich can do here. The start of the second. First drive since the quarter shift. Handoff is to Strawn. Strawn! About six, maybe. Or four, excuse me. I was way too high on that. 4 yards for Strawn. Strawn, again, has room. But Harpster is there. Third and two. Jardin in the middle of the D-line. Oh, it's swatted down. What a play to break it up. Just three, I think, was the target, but broken up by Lviv. And the punt team comes out. Kirker sending this pretty dang deep. Actually, just to the 20. Overstreet to return. Oh, my gosh. The lightning struck just as the hit came in. And that was a seizure inducer if ever I've seen it. Oh, my goodness. That's a highlight. That helmet popped off. The thunder rang out. My goodness. What a hit. Toller. What a hit. Torrey Toller, a gain of 3. Hand off, Lagendurfer. Just a couple inches. Third and 7. Villa is looking, firing, has a man wide open. It's Overstreet and the Lviv first down. Villa is 5 of 8. Triple back set. Hand off to Basil. Basil spins and he's up the middle. His first carry is impressive. Zaven Basil, 9-yard pickup. Love to see it. Now, second and short. 1 yard, it looks like. Deep handoff to Lagendurfer. He's going to make it more. Goat misses. Brendan missed the tackle. Lagendurfer down the sidelines. And what a run in Lviv. Putting a stamp on this thing right now. An 18-yard pickup by Roald Lagendurfer. What a run. Yeah. Basil in as the back. Vio goes deep down the sidelines. Just too far. Might have had him. Just a little far, though. For Vio. Aaron Vio. Lviv threatening to turn this into a two-score game. It's Lagendurfer. Up the middle, he'll get Brandon Goetz there again for third tackle of the day. Third and 8. The hometown Swiss calling for defense. Pressure's on, but oh, he fired it. He looked like he had him. Did Aaron Villa, but he fired it a little too hard for Overstreet. And that will set up a field goal attempt in this driving rain and thunder. Okoye, he hit one already. Okoye is nowhere close. He's 1 for 2 on the day, and it stays 3-0 Lviv loyalty against Zurich United. As the Zurich quarterback takes the field, but he'll hand it up to Strawn. Strawn up the middle. Strawn makes a few misses. Call it a gain of 13 or so. For Strawn, Rob Strawn, a gain of 13 indeed, on the Zurich 42. Trying to push past midfield. Lavi to Eaton, the backup back, and that's not what he wanted because Eduardo Palmore was there, and it's a loss of 3 for the backup. Now a triple back set in the eye, but a 2-minute warning is going to call that play dead before it ever started. In our last game of the day in this triple header, of week 1, number of highlights to show you after the fact. Lavi, oh, this is bad. Intercepted. It was batted at the line, and I'd love to see who batted that. Could have been Desjardins, even. But I don't. Can I see a replay? Who batted this one down? Was it our boy Desjardins? Oh, it was Zeke Desjardins. Or was it the helmet of the... Oh, it was the helmet, unfortunately. I don't think it was Zeke. It was the helmet of the old lineman. Gets beamed there. Unfortunately, it wasn't Zeke, but interception by Cosgrove. Yeah, it was the helmet, but nice effort from Zeke there to get those hands up nonetheless. And that'll give Lviv another shot in the plus territory. Oh, the pressure on Aaron Vieux was just too much. And he couldn't see the target. He might have had something on. It's a double back set now in second half. Snap. Way wide. Oh my goodness. What is wrong with Aaron Vieux right now? He's got plus territory and he hasn't put a single good throw out there yet. Inclement weather, maybe. Flight from Zurich. Difficult pressures on Warren. There's a completion to Cook. And a first down for Ukraine. He hits Cook. I think that's Cook's second big catch of the night. The Thunder still rolling through Switzerland here. Yeah. Pressure. He's got Edwards. Nice stand in there by Aaron Vieux and fires for another first. It's Menno Edwards. And Lviv is on the 14, looking to expand to a 10-point lead if they can get this in the end zone. Yeah, to Lagendorfer. His helmet comes loose. That's several times we've seen that today. Just a minute 10 left. They can't be lollygagging here. Can Lviv loyalty? Because they... You know, well, maybe they can, actually. They're so close to the end zone. Lagendorfer, uh-oh, that's going to cost you, though. It's Jesus Verberg Jean Jr. Nice tackle by Jesus. Timeout called by which team was it? Let's check the... It's by Ukraine, because they realize, oh, crap, we're wasting way too much time. Third and eight. Yeah. Dumps it. Lagendorfer for first down and then a bit. So they have a shot towards the end zone. That's 8 yards on the catch by Roald Lagendorfer. First and four to the end zone, essentially. Man in motion. Vieux dropping back. Vieux under pressure. Oh, he had his man. Christopher Cook. He dropped it, I think. Ouch. He had it in the end zone, but he dropped it. Make it second down. Zurich trying to hold. Zurich pressuring Vieux, but he has Overstreet. And a touchdown for Lviv loyalty. It's 10-0. A 9-play, 40-yard drive off that interception. And that opens the 2-score lead for Lviv. Vieux. Kick is up. And through. 10-0. The home fans in Zurich can't believe it. Kick is up. Okoye gets into this one. Called for a fair catch. Now, what can Lavi do to get his team back in the game? Strawn, as the Thunder comes in, he wrestles his way through. He could have, perhaps, if he was able to make that man miss, he had room. But a gain of 5 nonetheless. A good run by Robbie Strawn. Strawn out wide now. Not as good of a gain. Maybe 1 or 2 there. Make it 1. And time's a ticking. Looks like they're not going to press the gas pedal here. Even though they're trailing 10. Lavi. Hands off to Eaton, and it's been a bad day for Eaton, the backup tailback. 2 carries, both for losses of yardage. I'm surprised. It's 4th and 5. I'm surprised that Lviv's not calling a timeout here. Will they hut one play? Last time I asked that, the answer was no, and it's still no. So, it's the end of the first half, and it's all Lviv. The Loyalty are outgaining the United in every category here at the HFL Arena League Network. Lviv to receive while up 10. Chalkley, he missed the field goal earlier. A kick to the one, Overstreet. He's got a catch for a touchdown. Overstreet to the 22 of Lviv. Tracing Overstreet. Double back set deep in the backfield. Vieu is going to throw. Pressured, and that, you got to scratch your head on that one. That one went nowhere. Absolute ground ball from Vieu there. Second and 10. Vieu, deep hand off to Langendurfer. Oh, a huge stiff arm from Roald Langendurfer down the sidelines to the 40. What a stiff arm once he separated that man from his tackle attempt. There was nobody around, and he rumbled for 20. 20 big ones by Roald Langendurfer. That stiff arm was something to see. My goodness. Throw. Pressure. Oh, it's dangerous, but Overstreet's there to bail him out. Overstreet down the sidelines, and Lviv is making plays. It looked like he was left at a little low, a little off target, but Overstreet's there for it. Lviv. Langendurfer is a big reason they're succeeding. There's Goat on the tackle. Maybe an assisted tackle by Brendan Goat there. 4 yard pickup. Oh, it looks like they're showing blitz is Zurich. Nope, it's a fake blitz. Run is Basil, the backup. Nothing doing by Zaven. Third and 7. Zurich, you have to know, needs a stop here. They have to have a stop here. Yeah. Pressured. Pressure's big. He's dropping to Langendurfer, though. He's a man possessed today. A first down through receiving now. And that is a big, big play. Many on this drive for Langendurfer. Hiss. Hiss on the back. Or is it Kiss? No, it's Gene Hiss. A 5 yard pickup for his first tote of the day. Lviv is imposing their will on Zurich here. Vieu dumps to Tanner. Tanner. Verberg Jr. Jesus was there on the tackle. It was Maximus Tanner. Dragged down. Third and 2. Yeah, to Langendurfer. Oh, he's going to try to squeeze through, but he's held short. Fourth down, Lviv. Stuart Persing was there as they look to set up a field goal try. Make it 13 to nothing. Okoye up without trouble. It's 13 to nil, Ukraine. A 10-play, 64-yard drive. Zurich fans still looking for something to cheer about. Gavin. Cross the... No, just to the 19 of his own team. And as we look towards Lavi, the quarterback, can he make a play? Strawn. Nothing doing for Strawn. I think that was Desjardin on the play. Zeke with the tackle, perhaps. Let's see. Number 13 in the middle. I think he got him. Where's my end stay down? Oh, Zeke fell down there. Just when I said end stay down, the classic line. Simeon Eaton. He'll finally pick up a nice game. But it's 3rd and 5. Zurich already facing maybe a fourth quarter situation. Lavi swatted at the line. Was that our big boy? Nope. Moses Sesson credited with the swat. As Zurich searches for answers and Kirker punts again. Overstreet will return. Trout. Oh, a big tackle by Trout. A nice 10-yard pickup, though. Lviv, can they put this out of reach? Well, it's to say it's out of reach anyway, even with a touchdown, would be a little rich. Lagerdorfer, what a player he's been. Make it more. Lagerdorfer up the middle. Oh, he's, his own guy stunts him, but he still has blocks. Lagerdorfer, oh, he just ran out of steam. Lagerdorfer, excuse me, but a 37-yard run. That could have been a lot more. His own man turned into him, confused on the play. But what a player he's been today. Basil spelling him now, and he'll lose three. Pascal Warren on the run, or on the stop of the run, excuse me. Wow, Lagerdorfer's got to be player of the game right now, I got to think. What a monster so far. He's almost falling forward too much. Is he gassed? 7 yards per carry today for Roald Lagerdorfer, the Danish running back. Playing for Ukraine. Via to the air. Third down, pressure's heavy. Caught by a wrench. What a play by Wrench to catch it. It looked like it was congested to high degree, but Baron Wrench is there, and that'll end the third as Lviv looks unstoppable and Zurich can't get anything going here. Just 8 minutes left in what is currently a shutout. Lviv marching 13 to nothing. Lagerdorfer. Goat is there trying to impose his will from our Discord. 95 yards on the ground, Lagerdorfer. Today. Second and 7 for Ukraine. Deep pitch to Lagerdorfer. Up the middle. He'll gain 3. Rold is a train today. Posing his will on Switzerland. The fans waiting for something as the thunder rolls in. Vieux. Oh, it's swatted the line. A nice effort. Zurich is desperately holding on here to basically a 2-score game. It's about to be 2-8s here if they get this through. Okoye up. Oh, it splits and it's good. So it's 16-0 for Ukraine over Zurich. Devante Okoye is 3-for-4 today. Oh, he'll want this kick back, I think. Yep. Gavin returns from about the 18 or 16 up to the 32, 31. Zurich, you can hear them calling out too many mistakes, and that's been the case. Basically, the lone bright spot's been Jess Theory on the left-hand side of your screen. Lavi, he'll go to Theory. Theory catches it. That's her third catch or so tonight. HFL Arena is a inclusive sport, inclusive company. Dump to Trout, you'll see women here and there playing various positions. Trout with the first down, Hugo Trout. And that is something that Zurich needs really badly. Lavi, pressured, he'll get it to McKnight. And not Joe McKnight, it's Fabian McKnight. Rest in peace, Joe. 5 minutes left, a 2-score deficit, still time. The defense did what they had to do. Strawn. He's stuffed for nothing. 0-yard pickup. 3rd and 1. Time against them. Handoff is to Strawn. He's going wide. And how about Harrison? He sniffs it out. And he dropped him for a major loss. And you have to imagine that that's a punt after such a huge loss. Yes, it is. Kirker. We're going to pin him. Oh, that's a terrible punt. Terrible, terrible punt. It's a 26. Yikes. Will we see our first ever shutout as Vieux looks ahead? Lagerdorfer. He'll get nothing. But time is ticking, and that's as important as anything. Vieux, under pressure, has Basil, the backup running back, in the open. 9-yard pickup. This could be a backbreaker if they can convert here. 3rd and inches. What is Zurich made of on defense? Hand off. Toller. Oh, they're good for a stop because Toller went nowhere. And it's Kinsey Norfolk on the tackle, Mr. Norfolk. Punt. barren. Few times we've seen him today. It's a good one. But Gavin can return it. Oh, Overstreet ripped right through him, but they'll take it to the 26. So Zurich has still a chance here. Remember, it's still a two-score game. They'll hand it off to Eaton, the backup, and that was a bad play call because Simeon Eaton can't get anywhere with it, and it's precious time off the clock. As Lavi looks, see what he can do better. Dropping back is Lavi. Under pressure, he finds Trout. Trout down the sidelines. He can't beat Granquist, but he does have a first down. Here we are, 2-minute warning. 2 minutes down by two scores. Lavi hasn't shown much at QB. Strawn is trying to get a block in. It's a hanger. It's a bat down. And Lavi is just 42.9% tonight in front of Zurich faithful, and that's not going to cut it. That's why they find themselves scoreless so far. Lavi tries to run, but LeBec is there, brings him down, and Zurich goes backwards. Carroll LeBec, nice play by him. Break free, and Zurich now staring a 3rd and 17 down in the face. Lavi, thrown, completed, but for what good? I don't know. It was a gain of 1. Bert Bendorf makes the stop, and they have to go for it. 4th and 17 for all your marbles, all the tea in China. Lavi pressured, and that is never going to get it done. And Zurich has got to be wondering, what the heck did we put out here on tape today? Not a single good play on offense. Lagendorfer catches it, a shallow ball. Zurich will take up what it looks like to be at this point a futile timeout, but they could make a big defensive play perhaps, but we're staring at an easy shutout win on the road for Lviv Loyalty. Lagendorfer, oh, the defense still standing up. That's been their best part today, has been the defense, making those stops, but they're still allowed 16. 3rd and 8. Zerk doesn't get a stop, it's over. Lagendorfer, he'll get about 4, but it's 4th down and the final timeout is called. Pascal Warren on the stop, and that will bring out presumably the punt team. No, the field goal unit, my bad. I forgot where they were. They're on the Zurich 27. Of course, the field goal. This will put the game out of reach, in fact. And it's good. It's 19-0, and that definitely puts this thing out of reach, I would say. 5 yards gained is all they needed. My apologies on thinking they were in punt situation. Okoye gets into this one. Gavin, for 20. Can they at least get on the board, save some face in front of the home faithful? The United look anything but right here. United, Lavi fires. It should have been intercepted by Joctavius Howell. He had it in his mitts and he let it go. Right now, by far, Zurich has been the least impressive we've seen in this triple header. Wade is in the middle, but he's going to go to Trout for almost a first. 47, 46 and counting. 3rd and inches. Lavi firing deep. It's not on target. Oh, but LaCorte reaches out for it. It should have been intercepted, but he was bailed out by LaCorte. 1st down, Zurich, 37 seconds and ticking. No more timeouts, they'll spike it. It's all over but the crying. And Zurich wants to wipe a few tears with a touchdown. 35 seconds, Lavi, short range to Trout. That's not the kind of play they need. Trout's 4th catch though. 26 seconds, 3rd and 3. Lavi looking, firing, swatted down. Roger Granquist, we've called his name a few times, 4th and 3. This is it. If Zurich wants to avoid the goose egg, they got to do it now. Lavi, Desjardins on the pressure. He'll dump it to Strawn, though. Straw needs to go out of bounds, but doesn't. And that could be the end of the game here. 13 seconds, 12, 10. They've got to hurry. They don't have time for a spike, I don't think. No. Hail Mary. Last play of the game, perhaps. Down the field to Jess Theory. It's incomplete, and they'll get one more shot. Now it's all Hail Mary. Empty set for Lavi. Stack left, stack right. Short, though. It's not going to do it. Lavi, what is he doing out there today? It's a shutout for our third and final game of the week. We won't always do three games, but today we did. It's 19-0 for Ukraine, traveling to Zurich to get the big W. Yikes. Ugly for Zurich there. Player of the game, as expected, it's Roald Lagendorfer. He had 98 yards, a 5 average on 18 touches, a 37 long. No touchdown, though. I stand corrected. I thought he did. He also had 4 catches. Nice play by Lagendorfer. There is your man, Lagendorfer, for Lviv Loyalty Player of the Game. And congratulations for that honor. Let's take a quick look at the stats. A 48% from Valerian Lavi at 37 years old. That's just not going to get it done. Meanwhile, Vieux was 60% with one TD. Strawn was just 3 yards per carry, 10 for 31. Heaton was 4 for 1 yard total. Ouch. Meanwhile, Lagendorfer, we already said, second of receiving. Overstreet with 4 for 42 and a touch. Lagendorfer 4 for 31. Cook 2 for 25. Meanwhile, over at Zurich, we had Trout for 4 for 37. And we had Jess Theory 3 for 28. McKnight 1 for 19. Lacorte 1 for 19. Defense, Pursing led. Pursing and Goat, 9 tackles total. 1 TFL for our Discordee, Goat. A pass deflected for Warren. Now let's see defense for Lviv. Did Desjardins get any stats here? He had 1 tackle and he had a deflection. So it was him. They did give it to him then on the deflection. Good job, Zeke. Palmore, another pass deflected. 4 of 5 was Okoye, long of 55. Meanwhile, Chalky was 0 for 1. I think he tried a big bomb there. How far was it? Negative 3 fantasy points if you had Keenan Chalky in your starting lineup in fantasy. And the game. Well, everybody, I hope you enjoyed it. I sure did. We're going to advance the week here to week 2. But I won't be announcing who's playing on stream. But did my team lost Chalk River. Damn. Let's just go simulate game. Weekly wrap-up. Let's see if we get a newspaper story. I don't think we did. Check the injuries. Standing so far. Sheriffs won. Militia won. Whitetails lost and Badgers lost. Pride took the victory. Oil Barons won as well. Javelinas lost. Predators lost. Bandits won. Anglers won. That's in the new world. In the old world, Aberdeen Glory, Galway Raiders, and London Monarchs won. The Hereford Hounds lost. Cruisers and Howlers took the victory. If your player is on these teams, you'll get the stats in the Discord. Bowman, everybody lost over in the Renaissance Division. Loyalty and the Sword Saints, meanwhile, took the wins. And that's your look there. Let's take a look at injuries. Where is that again? Swear to God, there's injuries somewhere. Oh, news maybe? Yeah. Infirmary report, newspaper. Hawk Jr. on top with 4 field goals. But questions existence. 4 field goals. That's good for the Pamplona Bull Runners. Infirmary, any injuries? We've got my team losing a tight end to McLeod for what? 1 week. Kalowitz going to be out there running back for 1 week. Langdon out. Kyle out for the Miami Stars. Walker's down for a week. Kellerman, we saw him get hurt. That's 1 week. Verrett, 3 weeks. This is free safety. Backup free safety for Nova Scotia. He'll be out. Cook, 1 week. And that's it. So not too bad. Right now, Power Rankings has the lead going to Playa del Carmen Pride. First-ranked offense, fifth-ranked defense. And the worst team so far after 1 week? It's Miami Beach. The 28th offense, the 36th defense, the 18th best special teams. Ouch. The future star is looking for answers. Okay, guys. Future stats to come. Next stream will be week two. We'll see what the games will be. Catch you on Discord. Take care, everybody. Hope you had fun. I had a blast. See you next time.